This short video is to explore the relationships between two molecules that are non-superimposable mirror images of each other, and we call such molecules enantiomers. And three-dimensional models like these are great for establishing these relationships because you can manipulate them in actual three-dimensional space. So often things like this are represented in textbooks or on a computer screen, which is two-dimensional. And depending on the way they're represented, it can sometimes be not so obvious what relationships between molecules are. But in this case, we imagine that the carbon atoms which are in the middle are attached to four different substituents in each of these molecules, represented by those four different colors. Now, those four different colors may be individual atoms, like four different halogens, for example, or they can just represent four different substituents. But as long as they are all four different things, then each of these has a mirror image isomer, and we're seeing both of those isomers. If you imagine a mirror that would be positioned between these two, then when either of these molecules looks in that mirror, it sees the other one. And so these two molecules have the same relationship that your hands do. Your hands are non-superimposable mirror images of each other. They're very similar, of course, but they are not identical. And so that's why we sometimes refer to these molecules as having handedness or being chiral, because they have that same relationship. Now, another way to establish that these are not identical is if I pick up one of these and try to superimpose them atom for atom, I can get the red atoms to match up and the yellow ones, but notice that the green and the purple atoms do not match up. Or if I orient this so that the green and purple atoms do coincide and superimpose, now notice that the red and the yellow are not matching up. So no matter how I spin these around, I can't get them to perfectly superimpose. And that's what we mean to say that they are non-superimposable. With only one carbon that is chiral, one carbon that has four different substituents, that means there's only two of these isomers that are possible. If I build a third molecule like this one, it's going to necessarily have to be a duplicate of one of these two. And I can test for that superimposability to figure out for this third one which one it matches up with. And I can see I can get the yellow and red atoms to match up when I'm trying over here on the right-hand side, but notice the green and the purple do not match up, so that must mean that these are not identical. And therefore, it is identical to this isomer I had on the left. And if I slide this over so you can see, notice the reds match up, the yellows, the purples, and the greens. These two things are truly identical duplicates of one another. They are the exact same isomer. And both of them, again, are mirror image isomers of this other molecule on the right-hand side. So, as I say, a lot of times this is represented in two dimensions. Sometimes using representations of ball and stick models, in other instances using wedge and dash structures, and it's important to be able to interpret those, but nothing beats having an actual three-dimensional molecule like these that you can manipulate. And you can make your own models of these with gumdrops and toothpicks, as long as they're of different colors, so that you can establish these kinds of relationships here.